investments like buildings, you know, they speak volumes in terms of where you're placing priorities and what you believe in. And the ISE stands for everything that's happening at SLU in terms of interdisciplinary and cross-disciplinary efforts in STEM. That's just super exciting from every standpoint of the research and the teaching that I do.
The building itself came out of the recognition that we needed new science labs on campus. And then it was also clear that there were lots and lots of other people who had needs around the STEM community. At St. Louis University, we have strength in these areas.
Our main goal is to create future STEM leaders, right? We have to allow our students to use the technologies that scientists are using in the real world.
Whenever you go in that lab space, it was intentionally designed for our students. It gets their interest. It brings it alive.
The new building is going to have this amazing classroom in it. It's called the Scale Up Classroom.
The design is called Scale Up. I teach introductory courses. We used auditoriums, but the space did not allow me to do some of the things that I wanted to do in the class. The design of the new classroom revolutionizes participation. The podium is not the focal point. Everything that is projected will appear everywhere. Collaborative learning space gives much more access to every student. For SLU, it's such a wonderful fit with our values.
A competency that employers are searching for is students that are able to work in a team environment. The ISE building was built to bring students from different disciplines to work on real life projects. It's just phenomenal because that's another feather in our hat to promote why you should be recruiting here. Equally important, it gives them a chance to validate what's their vocation.
At the undergraduate level, we have new group project space, and so all of our students are required to do a year-long capstone project, delve deeply into an area that interests them, but really has a great impact on the students of how it sets off their careers and what their interests are as they move ahead from SLU.
SLU has been great in fostering interdisciplinary collaborations. The Interdisciplinary Science and Engineering Building is critical for interdisciplinary research. The Water Institute has three primary focus areas, so clean water access, protecting the aquatic ecosystem, and issues around infrastructure. It allows our investigators and our students to be co-located in new laboratory spaces.
The Center for Additive Manufacturing is basically a 3D printing center. It's really a sort of a collaboration center where you come in and explain what it is you want to accomplish, and we help you accomplish that. The goal of the center is really to be a resource for the entire university.
Having it in the central location, I think it's just going to bring in more collaborative, more interdisciplinary atmosphere. Students every day are going to be able to walk by and see what we're doing and see, oh, that looks really cool, that's really interesting. That's going to get them interested in this science, in this interdisciplinary field.
My research is in haptic and human-machine interfaces and technologies that encapture touch in new ways. I'm in the PATH group, which is People and Technology Horizon, that's working at really interesting problems at the nexus of people and technology. This building sort of represents everything that I've been looking for, this mingling of faculty, graduate, and undergraduate students from varying disciplines, new perspectives that come together. In terms of a collaborative researcher, can't ask for something better than that. I sort of see the ISE building as the pillar of something much larger. The impacts of that are going to be regional and likely much beyond regional.
Those people who are researching the newest viruses that are out there, the newest vaccines that we need, those are the students that are sitting in our classroom right now. And so if we can inspire that student to stay engaged in the STEM field and to stay engaged at St. Louis University, they're going to take that information and they're going to go all over the world with it.
When we look at big societal problems, climate change, pandemics, actually, how timely is that? Scientists are working on problems that require integrative approaches.
We wanted to absolutely make sure that the building was a place where faculty and staff and students and people from off campus could come and meet and collaborate together.
What can we do to help the community? Is there a startup close by that needs something prototype? Community outreach, that's one of our goals.
It's going to give us another venue to bring our employer partners on campus to showcase this is what we're doing to prepare our students. When you have students working with these companies, it keeps the talent here. There's no brain drain.
St. Louis is a wonderful place for STEM. We have the Cortex region, both startup and large companies actually there.
I hope we can expand the pool of talent that fills the St. Louis area STEM job workforce demands. This building represents a serious commitment by SLU to high-quality, state-of-the-art STEM education.
This building, it just makes it more creative, more inviting. It's more fun to study a hard course when you're in a cool building.
This building is a big symbol of all of the commitment we have at St. Louis University to not only allowing students the opportunity to pursue STEM careers, but in supporting them to do so.
We're putting in the efforts to educate the next generation. And we want that to be at St. Louis University.